Hey guys, this is my bracket I made. It's just a piece of wood. Put it on a small slant on the back and 45s on the side. So it sits in there. I don't think you can see it too well. But here's the wire coming out. And that will go into the mounting bracket, which will get mounted here. Let's get back a little bit here so you can see it. And then the motion sensor will go on. So I wanted it to tip down a little bit since it's so high up. I'll finish this part up, add a little silicone to the hole, and I'll show you what I got so far. Okay, so there's the motion sensor, and I'll see if I can zoom in. You can see the light's blue, and if I move, okay, it's out right now, now it's blue. So that is getting its power source from inside. All right, so a little cheapy motion sensor sends a signal to the camera, and I just use the outer pins for the motion sensor. Okay, and then the motion sensor gets its power here. I found a 5 volt or 12 volt? I think it's 12 volt. So I got a 12 volt power supply, 12 volt 2.67 amps, that's probably overkill. So I'll probably change this power supply out. But it runs 12 to 16 volts is what it needs. So when a motion is triggered, that triggers this camera. The camera doesn't really do anything besides tell Blue Iris that, hey, my trigger triggered, instead of the motion on the screen. So you don't have it do the screen because, you know, motion sensor's outside. So when it triggers, it's going to trigger a total of 3 cameras, this one and 2 others. The outside one that you've seen out there and then the front door. And I'll show you the software in a few minutes. Hey guys, this is the last part of the video. This is just to show you some of the settings that I had to change in Blue Iris and the camera. First thing you're going to want to check is the camera itself. Okay, I'm using an Amcrest camera, and right now I'm under alarms at the top here, and you can see I got one alarm. So when you set up the motion sensor to the camera and you want to test it, first thing you want to test is this right here. Once you start seeing these alarms come in when you're putting your hand or something, whatever, triggering the motion, and you start seeing those, then you know the two are working together. If you don't see these come in, Blue Iris ain't going to do nothing for you. So if we go under setup and under event, go to alarm, have it enabled, and I have it set to normally closed. I don't know what the default is, but I might have had to change that. I'm not sure. Video detection, I think that had to be on. When I went into the detection area, I removed all the areas on the screen. So this is normally what the camera sees. And you can draw a box on there. So if motion moves in front of that box, then it triggers and it records. Well, I removed them all. Okay. And that way I know if something moves in the garage, it's not going to trigger all the cameras. I'm not going to get any false alarms. But I'm pretty sure that had to be enabled. And I'm not going to test it right now. I'm not going to waste your time. Another thing is if you go to live, then I trigger my motion sensor, the alarm would go off. And when the alarm's going off, I know I'm good. Okay, that and the alerts. Okay, so once you get that, you'll go into Blue Iris. This is the camera that has the I/O inputs, the 4 low plugins in the back. If you don't have a camera that has those, you're not going to be able to get this working. So we'll go into the properties of this camera, and I'll show you a few things. First thing is under video, and then configure. You want to make sure you have get events with pull point subscription. That has to be checkmarked. If not, then it's not going to read those alerts. If you have a camera and you've tried everything, and you can see that the camera is detecting the alerts or the motion is triggering the camera itself, but Blue Iris still won't work, it could be this command line here. Okay,
the FOSS cam I had had issues, and I talked to Blue Iris, and they told me to change this line. They told me what to type in, and it started working. But for my Amcrest, I just chose Amcrest, Pro HD, RTSP. There's only three to choose from, and my camera works fine under this, and it picks up the alerts coming off of the back. Okay, so that's that. And then we want to go to trigger. Okay, and I'm pretty sure it's this one right here. Camera's digital input or motion. I'm pretty sure it's that one, but I also have this one check marked. I'm not sure why, but if you're in doubt, just check them both. It'll work. I don't think the global DIO input bytes, I don't think that makes a difference. I'm not sure. Then we go to record, and we have it set up to record. Now the motion sensor hooked up to this camera. This camera does not have to record if you don't want it to. It can just be used to trigger the other cameras. So I could take a check mark out, but I left it on in case someone came in the garage, that'd also be recording them in the garage to see what they're doing. Okay. There's no pre-trigger video buffer on this one. That basically means that if I was to turn it on, put 5 seconds here, it would record 5 seconds before the trigger, after, before it even went off. So then the computer is always recording 5 seconds and saving it, you know, for all the cameras. And I do have 2 seconds set up for the other cameras, I'll show you. But let's go back to trigger. When it's actually triggered, I have it set up to trigger a group, and the group is called outside. Okay, now we're all done in here. I'll show you what the outside group consists of. These three cameras. Okay, I'm gonna go back to all cameras. Now if I go over on this camera, if I go under trigger, as you can see, everything's unchecked because nothing's supposed to trigger this camera. The other camera's supposed to trigger it. Record, of course, is enabled. And here's my pre-trigger video buffer, 2 seconds. And that way, when the trigger, it gets triggered, it's going to save 2 seconds before it actually gets triggered. You can go more, but like I said, it's going to put a strain on the computer. Now, if I click a video, I got a video of me going outside here someplace, right here. So I'll click this one. As you can see, it was recording before I even got around the corner. The motion sensor's around the corner there. Okay, and which is this one here. See? Recorded just, it caught me just as I was peeking around, but it started 2 seconds before. So it's a good backup, I think. So that way you can see where they're coming from. Okay, so we'll close those out. I really don't get any false alarms now. If I do, it's because the tarp on the camper is blowing really hard. And, well, hopefully in the summer I won't have that tarp on there, and then it won't be doing that. And I won't get any false alarms at all. The other video clips you see on the side here are just because I was playing around and I was doing a force trigger for this video. So if I trigger it, as you can see, they all light up. They're all recording. So that's really about it. That's the settings that you need. You know, it's very easy to miss something in this setup. If you go into video, one of the things could be this command line, you know, but Blue Iris will help you with that. But the main thing is to make sure that you're getting the triggers from the camera itself. Make sure you log into the camera, you can see the events pulling, whatever. Once you know that's working, then come to Blue Iris and finish up your final details here and your settings, and then you're all set. Other than that, I can just go through real quick. I got those two checked. I have it triggering a group of cameras, which I don't have to. I could just tell it to trigger, you know, just this camera in the garage or just one. Record, I do have this one recording, but I don't need the garage one to record. I don't have a pre-trigger buffer on this one. I don't feel like I need it. and alerts. Alerts are totally up to you, but they're not necessary to get the cameras recording. I do have, if you notice, if I go to my work hours, I do have a send push notification to my mobile app. It works great on iPhone. It does not work very well on Android. So basically, when someone comes up my driveway and I'm at work, I get a push notification. And it sounds like a honking sound. It goes, honk, honk. Lets me know something triggered my camera, my motion sensor. So then I can open up the app and I can play the video clip back and I can instantly see, oh, someone came up the driveway. Oh, it's UPS guy, whatever. And I also have it working with my geofencing. So when I get at home, when I get to home, my schedule will automatically change as soon as I get home. So if I come home for lunch, it basically kicks back over to at home, which you can see it shuts off the notification. Okay, so that way it's not honking every time someone comes up my driveway. It only does it when I'm gone. So there's a lot involved in this, and you kind of piece it together the way you need it. I do have videos out there about the geofencing and stuff like that, so just take a look for them. If you have any questions, just let me know and I'll do my best at getting back to you. Take care.